I've been to so many gigs here, and it's like this place. It's everything you want from an underplay show. We wanted something that was raw, rough, and sweaty and loud, and like the balcony's gonna fall down. And where else would you go for such a strong vibe and character than Coco? I came through in Leeds with just me and a guitar. And the key to a small gig like that was to be able to lower your tone and lower your voice and bring the crowd right down with you and then bring them up. I could never ever be the solo artist. I'm a musician that's sat in upstairs rooms of bars for many years, and I could never ever forget who stood behind me. They are my family. I'm just a northern guy jumping around the stage, and they're the guys that are making this show worthwhile, because they're the really, really talented people that give me so much love and time and talent to be able to use to all of our benefit. We all work under just a name, which is my name, but that doesn't mean anything. We're all representing one thing. I think a lady was trying to touch my bum, but I instantly turned around and said, whoa, thinking somebody was touching my wallet, and my reply was, you're not gonna find anything there, I've just spent it all on that shirt. Because we like to go upper scale, we like to put everything we possibly can in, and people are going, whoa, what are you, you know, you're laying off five confetti cannons, and how much have you spent on this stage? And I don't care. It's important to give that time and effort back, so that's what I do, and I pile everything in there that I can to give people the best show they possibly can get. I don't want anyone to judge me. I want to kind of go, here I am. You know, I want to take a crowd and put them in my pocket and go, here I am. And this means so much to me, and I need to work this. And we're all in this together, and we're going to have an incredible night. And I'll work out how to do that.